What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and yes, today we are deploying our user state with SmartDeploy. On the last video, we actually captured it with SmartDeploy, which was super simple, and today we are actually deploying it. So let's get right into it. So within my environment, I created an additional machine, and it's called BTNHD-SD-3. That is the new machine that we are going to deploy the user state that we captured on the last video. Now, if I open up the documents folder, it is empty. All right, so to get started, we need to go inside your SmartDeploy server, open up your SmartDeploy console, go inside computer management, all computers, and we need to locate that new machine that you are going to provide your user, and you want to deploy that user's settings into that new machine. For us, it is BTNHD-SD-3. We are going to select it. You're going to get this nice side menu. And the option is right there, guys. Deploy user state. So let's click on that. You get this nice little menu right here. And it automatically points to the network path where the user states are located. So we are actually going to click on browse. And SD1 is the one that we captured. And I want SD1 settings to be pushed to SD3. So double click on that. Go inside the USMT folder. And we need to select that migration file and click on open. The next thing that we need to provide is a username and password that allows you to use that migration file and push it out to your machine. And we are going to click on finish. And it's going to give you a nice little dialog box stating confirm user state migration. Definitely click OK. And then, as always, the first column is going to change to a nice little clock. That clock basically states that it is pending. It is going to change to the following with a little guy with an arrow. And that basically means that it is pushing out those settings to that machine. Now, once it's completed, the little man is going to disappear on that first column. And then you are able to go back inside that machine, which for us was BTNHD-SD-3. And if you go inside the documents folder, you're going to see those folders and text files that we actually captured on the first video. Awesome. And if you were paying attention, look at the desktop. It actually took the Microsoft Teams and Google Chrome settings and pushed it out to this machine. And that's it, guys. Hopefully, you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to hit that thumbs up, smash that subscribe button, and do not forget about hitting that notification bell to get the latest and greatest from this guy. And I catch you guys on the next video. Peace out.